When I was growing up, my cousins lived in the city of Chicago, and I would go visit them every summer. The city holds a special place in my heart and also boasts a pretty cool history. If you couldn't tell from that little hint and my color scheme today, we're talking about the Great Chicago Fire. Hello everyone, my name is Evie and welcome back to my channel. On October 8, 1871, a fire broke out in the city of Chicago that killed 300 people, burned down a third of the city, and left 100,000 people homeless. Legend has it that a cow belonging to a woman named Mrs. O'Leary knocked over a lantern, setting the entire city ablaze. Catherine O'Leary later denied this charge, and the true source of the fire remains a mystery to this day. That being said, there are quite a few well-known factors that led to the fire becoming as devastating as it did. One, most of the buildings in the city at the time were entirely made of wood. Since wood is an organic material made of carbon-based life forms, it combusts easily, leading to the spreading of the fire. Two, most of the buildings were topped with highly flammable tar or shingle roofs. Tar is another organic material that has carbon in it and again can easily be set aflame. Three, all of the city's sidewalks and many roads were also made of wood. 5. Strong southwest winds helped carry burning embers directly into the heart of the city. 6. At the time, the Chicago Fire Department had only 17 horse-drawn vehicles as their main form of transportation to protect the entire city. And 7. The department watchmen initially sent firefighters to the wrong location, allowing the fire to grow unchecked. This disaster prompted an outbreak of looting and crime across the city. Soldiers were summoned to the city of Chicago and martial law was instituted on October 11th, ending 3 days of chaos. Martial law was lifted in the city a few weeks later. In the month after the fire, a man named Joseph Medill was elected as the new mayor of Chicago after promising to institute stricter building and fire codes. This promise might have helped him win office. Just a little bit. His victory could also be linked to the fact that most of the city's voting records had been destroyed in the fire, making it basically impossible to stop people from voting multiple times. The city at this point was quite literally a hot mess, but not for long. Reconstruction efforts began quickly and led to great population growth and economic development for the city. Architects were able to lay down the foundation for a modern city, including some of the world's first skyscrapers. After the fire, laws were passed requiring buildings to be constructed using fireproof materials such as brick, stone, marble, and limestone. The city's population rapidly increased in the next decade and continued to grow. In 1956, the Chicago Fire Academy was built on the grounds where Mr. and Mrs. O'Leary's farm once stood. That very school trains firefighters to this day. The Great Chicago Fire has taught us a lot, including not to make a city out of entirely flammable materials. That's it for today's video. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for more videos every single week. And remember that science is everywhere. But Evie, this is history, not science. Actually, science is everywhere.